Keeping in mind Bangladesh's future economic challenges, it is important for the country's leaders to adopt poverty reduction strategies that are sustainable in the long run. A sustainable and promising poverty reduction process is visible in the Making Markets Work for the Poor approach, in short, M4P. The purpose of this video is to share the key features of the M4P approach, as well as to show few examples from the implementation experiences of the project called Katalyst. Katalyst has applied this approach and achieved positive results in reducing poverty.
দারিদ্র নিরসনে টেকসই প্রবৃদ্ধির কোনো বিকল্প নেই। তবে শুধু প্রবৃদ্ধি হলেই দারিদ্র দূর হবে এমনও কিন্তু কথা নেই। খেয়াল রাখতে হবে যে প্রবৃদ্ধির ফসলটা কার ঘরে উঠছে। যদি অল্প সংখ্যক মানুষ এই প্রবৃদ্ধিটা খেয়ে ফেলে বেশি সংখ্যক মানুষ কিন্তু প্রবৃদ্ধি থেকে অনেক দূরে সরে যাবে সেই জন্য সাম্যভিত্তিক উন্নয়নের কোনো বিকল্প নেই আমাদের যে আয়ের যে বৈষম্য এটা সব সময় কমিয়ে আনবার চেষ্টা করতে হবে দারিদ্র নিয়ে অনেক দিন যাবত কাজ করছি সারা দেশেই কাজ হচ্ছে দরিদ্র মানুষের সংখ্যা যেমন কমছে দারিদ্রের মাত্রাও তেমন কমতে শুরু করেছে প্রায় গত এক দশকে প্রায় 1.5 কোটি মানুষ দারিদ্র রেখার উপরে উঠে গেছে সুতরাং এই যে সম্ভব হলো এটা কেন এর একটা বড় কারণ যে আমরা একটা ইনক্লুসিভ গ্রোথ অর্থাৎ আমরা সবাইকে সঙ্গে নিয়ে হাঁটবার একটা চেষ্টা করছি
There are key differences in the traditional and the M4P approach. Traditional project supports the poor by directly providing them with knowledge, goods and services. While such a direct approach can achieve quick results, its sustainability is frequently limited. Is often unable to reach large number of beneficiaries and may also have a distortionary effect on markets. M4P approach works indirectly. In the M4P approach, the underlying constraints of the market system are first identified. Interventions are designed to facilitate to overcome the constraints. These interventions lead to sustainable change in those market systems which are important for the poor. M4P is not just an approach adopted by projects. Rather, it is a framework which can guide poverty reduction strategies for governments, donors, and development agencies.
There are some key features of the M4P approach. While designing an M4P intervention, it is important to identify the key constraints in a sector. We need to identify the market system which, if improved, can benefit the poor in the sector. And in doing so, we also need to understand who the leverage points, be it private or public, can be worked with so that they reach a large number of SMEs or producers in the sector. We also need to be careful about the incentives they have. These incentives in the long run address the sustainability of the intervention. As M4P projects, we also need to be careful of our role, which should be more of a facilitation. We need to provide the required support to these leverage points so that they can build their own capacity to perform a better role in the sector in the interest of the poor. Also, as M4P projects, since the sectors are dynamic, we also need to perform quality monitoring and evaluation. We need to monitor our activities in the field, identify what benefits it had had on the poor in the sector, and design follow-up interventions to increase the impact and outreach.
M4P projects work on sectors that are important for the poor. In other words, sectors that involve a large number of poor people as producers, employees, or consumers are competitive and have potential for inclusive growth. This signifies the potential to improve productivity and income of the poor people. Have potential for change, which means it is possible to bring about changes in the market systems by addressing the underlying problems. Thus, the M4P projects work on sectors that have all three criteria mentioned. Katalyst has been working in around 30 sectors since the beginning of the project in 2003. The current portfolio consists of core and cross sectors. Core sectors are agricultural commodity markets. These are maize, vegetables, prawn, jute, potato, fish, furniture and crafts. Cross sectors are supporting markets to the core sectors and can be product or service. These are seed, fertilizer, irrigation, information communication and technology, packaging, media, local agricultural network and distribution. Considering the incentives of the market players, which also involve the poor, activities are designed in such a way that a win-win situation prevails and everyone is benefited in the long run. In this case, the project's objective is poverty reduction and the public or private sector's objective is policy change or business or financial gain, respectively. Yet everyone wins at the end to meeting the beneficiary's objective of gaining access to improved services and information. In the win-win situation, we see that the project in the public or private sector may have different objectives, but they can still have a common interest. Katalyst has partnered with a number of public and private sector agencies in the seed sector. Lal Tir is one of them. Seed is a key agricultural input and its quality has a substantial effect on crop yields. A steady supply of quality seed to farmers can significantly improve their production.
With the support of Katalyst, we have done 420 retail training programs in Rangpur, Rajshahi, Bagura and Jeshur about the use of better seed. So the farmers are well equipped to know that when they will be sowing the seed and what kind of treatment they should be doing during the cultivation system, when the plant grows, when the transplantation is done, or during the harvesting time. The unique part of this training program was to train the MSVs, mobile seed vendors. So we have trained them about the need or necessity of the seed packing and to write what the seed contains, right? The moisture content of the seed, the dryness of the seed, the germination of the seed, the vigor of the seed, and the timing of sowing.
The introduction of the mini packs, as we said, another innovation from Lal Tir, and in fact, it was catalyzed by Katalyst itself. We have sold packs, big, large, and small, and finally, we have mini packs. If you look at worldwide, we look at food, spices, beverages, everything is becoming into mini sizes, which is easier to consume, easier to store, and easier to carry. So with the introduction of mini packs, what allows Lal Tir is to touch up on marginal farmers who may not have land, who may have borrowed or hired land. This allows the entry into a whole new dynamics where housewives can have kitchen gardens, marginalized farmers can use smaller plots of land. So Lal Tir actually foresees that in our business paradigm, there'll be a large shift from the larger size packs, which is in the majority right now, to a larger volume of mini-size packs in the near future.
One of the common problems that farmers in Bangladesh have is access to adequate agricultural information. This leads to low productivity, low yield, and low income. Using this as a focus, Katalyst started to explore ways on how we can address this problem. Three centers, two from Digital Equality Network and one from Broadlink, were opened towards the end of 2005 and early 2006. They were called Ghat and Alakudagram. These centers were commercially driven and provided its customer with a range of information services and other ICT-based services like composing, browsing, emailing, and digital photography. The results of these centers were very impressive. We found not only farmers benefiting in terms of getting increased access to information, but also these centers showed increasing signs of promising sustainability. Based on these results, we decided to scale it up. We decided to work with a partner. Our search led us to Grameenphone, who were also doing a similar initiative during that time.
Grameen Phone is one of the largest telecom operators in Bangladesh with the widest nationwide coverage.
We started with a pilot covering 16 CICs, and the results was overwhelming, and we quickly decided that this was something that we would like to roll out across the country. Then we needed a good partner for this, and we ended up teaming up with Katalyst, basically due to their knowledge and experience, the agriculture sector in particular. And together we rolled out more than 500 community information centers. We have been working with Katalyst in order to develop these centers in order to increase the benefits for the farmers, making them more relevant, adding new applications like eKrishok and the fertilizer information service. And we do see that it is important to continue to develop the content at the community information service in order to increase the usability for the farmers.
The story here shows how a private company can bring significant changes to the lives of the poor people.
আমার নাম মোসাম্মদ চায়না খাতুন। আমি প্রথমে দেড় বিঘা জমিনে কৃষি কাজ শুরু করি এবং সেখানে বেগুন লাউ আর চাল কুমড়া দিয়ে শুরু করি। একদিন হঠাৎ করে আমার বেগুনের সমস্যা হয়। তারপরে এই সমস্যার সমাধান আমি অন্য কোথাও জানতাম না। সিআইসি থেকে এক মহিলা আপা এসে আমাদের উঠান বৈঠক করে, করার পরে ওখান থেকে আমাদের এই সমস্যার কথাগুলো বলে দেয়, সিআইসিতে সমাধান পাওয়া যাবে এবং আমি তার কাছে যাই যে ওই সমস্যার সমাধানটা নিই। কীটনাশকটা দেওয়ার পরে আমার বেগুনে যে সমস্যাটা ছিল সেটা ভালো হয়ে যায় এবং যে টাকায় বিক্রি করার কথা ছিল তার থেকে ডবল টাকায় বিক্রি করছে। করার পরে আমাদের বাড়ির আশেপাশে আরও অনেক চাষিরা আমার কাছ থেকে জানার পরে সিআইসির মাধ্যমে তারাও অনেক উপকৃত হয়।
Katalyst is working with the government to promote a quality enhancing and water saving jute retting technology.
কৃষি মন্ত্রণালয়ের মাননীয় কৃষি মন্ত্রীর উদ্যোগে এই কাজটা আমরা সম্প্রসারণের চেষ্টা করছি। এই ক্ষেত্রে আমাদের সাথে Katalyst 2010 সনে আমরা তাদের সাথে একটা এমওইউ করি। সেই সুবাদে ওনারা এই রেবন রেটিং পদ্ধতি কৃষক পর্যায়ে ছড়িয়ে দেওয়ার জন্য এবং জনপ্রিয় করার জন্য কাজ শুরু করেছেন এবং অলরেডি ওনারা 50টি ডেমনস্ট্রেশন করেছেন। এতে 2000 জন চাষি এই ডেমনস্ট্রেশন প্রশিক্ষণটা গ্রহণ করেছেন।
The graph here shows that although a direct approach can have a quick impact, the M4P approach, which takes a bit more time, can bring sustainable impact in the long run. Direct approaches can only give results for as long as there is external aid or subsidy, whereas the benefits of an M4P approach are sustained by the changed market system, even after the external aid or assistance ends. M4P clearly can be summarized as, first, sustainability, to create incentives for the market actors and build their capacity to continue engaging the poor in their business practices without any external support or financial aid. Second, crowding in. The changing business environment with new incentives and opportunities prompts other market actors to copy. Third, and finally, changing market systems. To bring meaningful changes to the lives of the poor people, we need to change the systems to make them work better to serve their needs. Whether we call it M4P or a market development approach, it has been showing signs of success in changing markets.